Coming up, 9 hours of nonstop tournament action, beginning with Texas Tech taking on Gonzaga. And then at about 3:20 p.m. Eastern Time, Pacific will meet top seed Washington from Boise. Utah State battles Oklahoma State in Tucson. Among the schools in action in our third set of games, another top seed, Illinois, faces Nevada, and UAB takes on Arizona. The quadruple header games tip at about 8 Eastern Time, with West Virginia against Wake Forest and Cincinnati against Kentucky. As we head further down the road today, let's open the Hartford Thinking Ahead playbook and talk about what you guys expect to see this afternoon. If this game is going to go right for Texas Tech, if it's going to go right for Gonzaga, what do you see?
Well, I'll start with Texas Tech. For them, they've got to force turnovers. That's when they're at their best, when they're able to use their speed on the perimeter to be disruptive at the defensive end. That negates the advantage that Gonzaga has up front. So pressure defense is key, and also their ball movement on the offensive end of the floor. They really do a nice job getting high quality shots for their good perimeter players, but I think Gonzaga is going to show them a zone and make it much tougher for them in their motion offense.
And I'm going to be watching closely in the first few minutes how this game is going to be officiated. Remember when Gonzaga was eliminated last year, Roni Turiaf basically spent the whole game on the bench because of foul trouble. Obviously, if they can't maneuver their size, take advantage of that advantage inside, that's going to hurt them. But Texas Tech is a great offensive team, and neither one of these teams really play great defense. So can Texas Tech execute their motion offense against Gonzaga's perimeter defense?
What do you like in this game?
I like Gonzaga.
I like Gonzaga as well. And also, one of the other factors that we can never really anticipate fully or know exactly where it's going to happen is who's going to be Texas Tech's or Gonzaga's Vermont's Jermaine Mopajila, the guy who steps up and does something beyond what he normally does in a ball game.
Who's going to be Texas Tech's Gonzaga's?
Who is Mopajila?
Yeah, right. Exactly.
Look for the Mopajila.
That's
the
right.
Texas
go.
Tech against Gonzaga is next from Tucson. Kevin Harlan and Dan Bonner standing by to call the action. We'll join them courtside after this word from your local station. Enjoy the second round of the madness here on CBS.
The Greater Houston area Pontiac GMC dealers.
Arizona and the McHale Center for the second round of the NCAA tournament. Our feature game, 6-seed Texas Tech against 3-seed Gonzaga. Gonzaga beating Winthrop, and Tech took care of UCLA. Hi, everyone. With Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan, thank you so much for joining us today. Texas Tech, Dan, shot 61% against UCLA. Why were they so successful?
Well, it was remarkable execution on offense. Now, Bob Knight didn't invent the motion offense, but his team may have perfected the principles. We'll illustrate those principles there. The guys in the circle, screener and guy coming off the screen, and the X's are the two defensive players. And what the principle of motion offense is, you come off the screen, you read what the defenders do. In this case, they drop back, so you react to that. And when you have a guy like Ronald Ross that can make that open jump shot, it really is poetry in motion.
If Gonzaga is to advance, who has to play well for the Bulldogs?
Well, I think Adam Morrison is one of their key guys. Obviously, he's a tremendous scorer. This guy, a great story. You can see the game that he had the other night. I think he's got to play well simply because he creates such a matchup problem.
The Red Raiders from the Big 12, the Bulldogs from the West Coast Conference. Our tip-off is next as the road to St. Louis continues.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the Men's Basketball Championship is sponsored by Applebee's Neighborhood Grill and Bar, Radio Shack, New Budweiser Select, and by Pontiac.
When this room is booked, a Janus investment is working.
Enterprise, we'll pick you up.
It's time now to look at the first round nominees of the Pontiac game-changing performances. Number one, West Virginia's Tyrone Salley blocked a three-point attempt, then finished a fast break with the game-winning dunk against Creighton.
Number two, Florida's Anthony Roberson put back a miss and converted the three-point play to enable the Gators to overcome Ohio. Number three, TJ Sorrentine had 5 three-pointers and 17 points total in Vermont's overtime win over fourth seed Syracuse in the Catamounts' first ever tournament win. Number four, Chris McNaughton connected on the game-winning jump hook with 10 ticks on the clock as number 14 Bucknell upended number three Kansas. Take action and vote now at NCAAsports.com/Pontiac and choose your favorite performance. Pontiac will donate $5,000 to the winning school's general scholarship fund.
Sportsline. We've got the tournament covered.
Our game today from Tucson is being brought to you in HDTV by the Harris Corporation, the world leader in broadcast systems for high-definition television. With Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan, we're at the McHale Center on the University of Arizona campus. Texas Tech and Gonzaga. Bob Knight is in his fourth season with the Red Raiders. He had all those great seasons at the University of Indiana. And his starting five, Dan, is highlighted by the great shooter, Ronald Ross.
Well, not only did he have 28 points, but he also had 7 rebounds and 3 steals the other night. A tremendous, complete player.
Mark Few is in that pile someplace in his sixth season. He has had a great deal of success up in Spokane, Washington with this team. And we talked about Adam Morrison in our open.
And I think you got to look for the inside power today. Roni Turioff and J.P. Batista, I think, are very, very critical for the success of the Zags.
Our officials today, Bob Donato, J.D. Collins, and Tony Green. The Texas Tech, the Red Raiders at 21-10, the 6th seed. The Gonzaga Bulldogs at 26-4, the 3 seed. Against Winthrop, Gonzaga shot 46%. And as we mentioned before, the great shooting over the Bruins by Texas Tech. They also outscored UCLA by 20 points in the paint at 5 more rebounds than the Bruins.
And this is all with a 3-guard lineup, but these are guards who can rebound and who can defend and who can play in the post.
And they'll toss it again. The winner of this game in this Albuquerque Regional will take on the winner of Wake Forest and West Virginia. Ronny Turioff jumping against Devon Giles, and that's out of bounds as well. It will go to Gonzaga.
So thus far, we've had trouble keeping the ball on the court. Now the teams want to keep the ball on the court, Texas Tech in particular. They really struggle when they turn the ball over. They did not have many turnovers against Utah or against UCLA the other night. Man-to-man.
Turioff on top. He's picked up by Daryl Dora. Batista, who played well, fighting in there against Giles. And the loose ball is vacuumed in by Ronald Ross. And he'll fly the other way, working around Knight. And out of bounds.
Well, already I think we see some interesting matchup. Ronald Ross is going against Earl Knight, number 22 in white, who's the WCC Defender of the Year. And Gonzaga worried about that motion offense before Texas Tech comes out in a 2-3 zone on the underneath out of bounds play.
Martin Zeno. And Turioff, who collected 13 rebounds the other night, picks up his first right there. Rybio tonight slashing in from the side.
And that's what Gonzaga wants to do. They would really like to get the ball out and push it down the court before Texas Tech can set the defense. Now Gonzaga drops back into the man-to-man.
A mismatch here with Zeno picked up by the taller Morrison.
It's a 3-guard offense, so Texas Tech is going to have mismatches like that. And there is a tremendous basket by Giles. Giles was 7 of 8 the other night against UCLA. He's a fellow who can score inside.
Grab 9 rebounds, too. Knight tried to penetrate. Got it off to Morrison. And now in to Roni Turioff. He's a senior. He's from Martinique, and he has been in this program during all their successful runs.
And it's 6'10", 250 pounds. That's a very difficult matchup for Daryl Dora. Again, the man-to-man defense, being able to pressure the ball is going to be critical. Rybio did a nice job right there.
It was a week ago when Texas Tech played in the Big 12 postseason championship game in Kansas City at Kemper Arena against Oklahoma State, losing by 4. Giles again with the puck, the second rebound by Terry off of Gonzaga.
And only white shirts around the board that time. Texas Tech, they got burned by that run out. They dropped back quickly.
Rivio for 3. He was 2-10 the other night. And a nice rebound by Ross. Waddle Ross is out of Hobbs, New Mexico.
Texas Tech wants to get that motion offense going quickly. Their guard play, physical guard play, you saw it right there. Jackson takes the ball into the lane and jumps up into Rivio to draw the foul.
Look at Bob Knight, who with his 27th NCAA bid ties Dean Smith for most all-time by head coaches in college basketball. As you take a look at Jarius Jackson, sophomore from Monroe, Louisiana. And he had a great night the other night with 19 points and 6 assists and 4 rebounds.
He's nearly an 82% free throw shooter. He doesn't miss many, and this is 2 there.
Rivio, and slips it inside of Turia. They're trying to establish, it seems, earlier in this game than they did the other day.
Absolutely. If there's an advantage for Gonzaga, it is their power inside, particularly Kurioff and Batista. If there's an advantage for Texas Tech, it's on the perimeter. And there's the big advantage right there. Ronald Ross doing a great job getting loose from Knight, continues his hot shooting.
Now they go into Batista, who's been working off that left block the entire season and finds success there. Batista had 14 points just like that the other night.
Right, really emphasizing going inside. Kurioff, you can see how much time he has with the ball. Texas Tech's going to have to consider a double team there, but Ross, so quick. Again, he comes off that screen. That's the motion offense. Coming off the screen, reading the defender's reaction. The defender doesn't get over the screen, so he pops the jump shot.
So here is the Brazilian J.P. Batista. Gonzaga by 4, and this equals their biggest lead so far over the Red Raiders.
And they drop back into the zone defense.
Texas Tech in Big 12 conference play. The regular season finished 10-6. Ross fouled, counted for 2, and they'll send him to the stripe with a good-looking shot. Rivio was there, and Knight was there, and they put it on Knight of Gonzaga for the first time.
You know, just because the team's playing a zone doesn't mean you can't use screens. They're a great screen out top. Rivio gets picked off, and in a zone, Kevin, there's nobody really to come and help out on that screen. So a nicely executed play by Texas Tech.
Tech to within 1, and they have not had a lead in this game so far. Rivio and Morrison slithering on that baseline and knocked away. Zeno met him and a foul. Gonzaga by a point. CBS Sportsline puts you on the court for this year's men's NCAA tournament. Get up to the minute scoring and streaming video highlights for every second round game at CBSSportsline.com. At the free throw line is sophomore Adam Morrison, 6'8", Spokane, Washington.
And he is really going to be a tough matchup problem. His numbers from the other night, but at 6'8", he handles the ball very well, quicker than you think. He likes to get close to the basket, and he's going to be able to jump up over top of those smaller guards. Gonzaga now showing some pressure.
Either team has made a change to their starting lineup. We're approaching 4 minutes into this first half.
Gonzaga playing in that zone. The reason you play zone against a team like Texas Tech, lots of times a team that emphasizes motion, this offense will stand around a little bit against the zone.
Zeno beautifully to Ross, who couldn't convert. And Turioff grabs another rebound, his 4th collected so far. Earl Knight for 3. It took some hesitation on the official, but that 3 ball by Knight has just given Gonzaga a lead of 13-7, their biggest of the game. They're off to a good start in this round of 32.
Green Jackets, the Masters on CBS.
Gonzaga really would like to get the ball up the court quickly. You're going to see the ball come here and then go right down the court to Knight. This is what they want to do. They want to push it up before the defense gets set. You see the black shirts running back, but they're not quite set yet. Knight getting that bucket.
They've given Knight a two ball instead of the three-point shot. His right foot was on the arc, and the officials went over there and took a look at the replay and have made the correct call, and neither team made a change out of that timeout. And here comes Martin Zeno with a little bit of space to fire.
One of the ways that you can break down a zone defense is with penetration off the dribble, and Zeno has done that.
Loss for Texas Tech, leads all scorers with five. Ronnie Turioff has 4 points and four rebounds so far for Gonzaga. Again, off that left block is Batista. A fifth rebound by Turioff, who pulls the trigger but can't get it to go.
Well, that strength by Turioff.
And takes it in for two.
Offensive foul.
Wipe it away.
Well, you know, you're a big, strong guy like Turioff. You get the ball inside on the rebound. The double team comes now. He's trying to power up. He misses now. He's really mad that he's missed it, so he's going to get it and really try to power it up, and he gets the foul.
Giles wasn't looking for the pass, and luckily it ricochets back on top, so Tech keeps it as we're 5 minutes into this first half. Texas Tech has gone 4 of 8 from the field to start the game. Zeno, double team, and he's hit two in a row.
And Zeno is a guy, one of those high-scoring guards. He only had 4 points the other night, but he has been very active in the middle of that zone thus far today.
Gonzaga has started the game 5 of 9. This is Morrison. Fouled. Count it.
And that's where Zeno has the problem. Morrison, we mentioned, 6'8". Zeno only 6'5", so Morrison, and again, we said he's quicker than you think. He beats Zeno to the baseline off the dribble. The little bump gets himself some space, and then he knocks it down. He is deadly with that mid-range game.
We told you before that Morrison grew up in Spokane. Of course, that's the home of Gonzaga, and he was a ball boy, was Morrison, growing up as a young guy. And now, of course, playing for the team he idolized as a child. Can't complete the three-point play, but does get the miss, and they call it a tie-up inside with Giles of Texas Tech.
Very interesting. The free-throw shooting has not been very solid here so far today for either team, and both teams are excellent free-throw shooting teams.
Sean Mallon has come in for Ronnie Turioff. Texas Tech has never led in this game. Gonzaga's lead has been as high as 5.
Gonzaga trying to be a little bit more active in the zone.
Ross with the miss. And he has started 2 of 5. Gonzaga leads in rebounding by 2 so far. Batista, this time off the right block, which has not been where he has succeeded in this tournament. But a great rebound, and jumping back up was Knight.
You know, Kevin, Batista was too slow in there. He allowed double and triple teams to come, but that ended up working out because when he missed the shot, there was no block out for Texas. Knight having a big game so far.
Rivio is on Zeno.
And Texas Tech trying to solve that zone. They've done a nice job with some dribble penetration.
And mainly by Zeno, who's got it now. And they go from Giles, and a beautiful pass to Daryl Dorr, the sophomore from Gonzales, Texas, who cut well.
A lot of people think you beat a zone by shooting over, but you beat a zone by getting inside it. Dribble penetration, now the excellent interior pass.
Dorr is on Mallon. Now Batista on the right side working on Giles. Morrison.
Well, that's great defense by Ross.
Rivio and Knight for 2 over Zeno. Great offensive rebound by Mallon, who is hacked at inside and fouled. It looked like maybe Giles or Dora. They were both there in there fighting for that loose ball. Well, yesterday, as Giles picks up his first foul, we saw some mammoth upsets, and none bigger than Bucknell beating the third seed Kansas Jayhawks in Oklahoma City late last night.
The first time a Patriot League team has ever won an NCAA tournament game, and that Vermont Syracuse game. Big shot of that game was that three-pointer that was from about half court.
They take Knight out, and they put in Pierre Maria Altidore Cespedes, who is a freshman out of Montreal for Gonzaga. And at the free throw line is Mallon.
Gonzaga's play on the boards, their inside play, has been the most significant factor so far in the game. 5 offensive rebounds for the Zags. None for Texas Tech.
Jarius Jackson. Caught for 2 and a foul. Jackson with the move, coming off a 19-point game against the Bruins on Thursday.
Boy, this is just excellent recognition by Jackson. He finds the seam in the zone and drives through there. And Jackson is not a small guy, very strong, 6'1", 185 pounds.
As I mentioned, the 19 he has Thursday against UCLA. He had 22 in the Big 12 championship game against Oklahoma State. So he's put together two very sound games. He's only averaging 14 a game, so he's well above his average so far in postseason play. Rivio, Altidore, Cespedes, and Mellon. And we got a 3 second inside. And a turnover. Tomorrow on CBS, a housewife is murdered. Now 20 years later, new clues lead detectives to a neighborhood full of suspects. Don't miss a new cold case. It's tomorrow here on CBS. With Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan. The Red Raiders to within two of Gonzaga. Bulldogs have led by as many as five.
Texas Tech has done a nice job attacking this zone, again, mainly with dribble penetration.
Zeno on Morrison, and the shot clock is down to 10. Missed by Ross, the rebound by Morrison, who gallops the other way, facing the defense of Zeno. A screen by Mellon sets up that two-point shot. Mellon screen, open the door.
But Morrison is just so smooth shooting the ball. He's got that sort of herky-jerky run about him, but boy, when he starts going up for that shot, nothing herky-jerky at all about it.
He's 2-2 so far. Dora, Ross, Altidore, Cespedes on him. Rivio on Jackson.
Now, you don't want to get into the habit of doing nothing but dribbling against the zone.
There is a lot of that going on right now as they try to get a feel for things. The foul goes on Rivio of Gonzaga. They've led the entire way, now by four.
For more information and to open a no-fee Roth IRA, call 1-800-FIDELITY. You can do it. Smart move.
It's Gonzaga by four. We told you a cute little story moments ago about Adam Morrison while growing up in Spokane. He was a ball boy for the Bulldog basketball team.
Also diagnosed at age 13 with type 1 diabetes. And what you see him doing there before the game is testing his blood levels. During the normal times, he wears an insulin pump. Can't do that during a game, so he's got to test his blood levels every time out. Sometimes he just takes a drink of juice, sometimes a power bar. Once in a while, he's got to give himself a shot over there. It's truly an amazing story.
Starting point guard for Gonzaga, Rivio's got two fouls, so they brought back in Turiop. They've kept in Altidore Cespedes in the game, coupled with Knight in the Gonzaga backcourt. Gonzaga by four, inside to Ross, who makes it work as he slashes for two. He's got a game-high 7 points.
And coming out of that timeout, not quite so much dribbling by Texas Tech as they moved the ball very effectively, got it inside with the pass.
Morrison on Ross. Morrison hasn't missed. He is 3 of 3. He's got a game high 8.
And that 6'8 frame just going on the inside, going up over the 6'2 Ross. And Rivio being out of the game for Gonzaga is really significant. He averages 36 minutes a game, almost never comes out in a big game like this, but he's got to sit down with those two fouls.
This is such a different defense that Texas Tech is playing now as opposed to what they saw Thursday against UCLA.
That was a man-to-man defense that they faced against UCLA, and here there's been this very active zone. They've had some success with dribble penetration, but you don't want to spend a lot of time dribbling out on the perimeter.
Shot clock at 2 for Jackson for 3. And saved by Zeno, circles around Turioff, and with the left hand, got it away. But Mellon grabs the loose ball.
Well, you see Morrison really trying hard to push the ball up the court, but Texas Tech effective getting back.
Turioff into Dora.
Oh, that's just power. That is just power in there.
Turioff has 6 points and 6 rebounds. He's given Gonzaga their biggest lead this afternoon of 6. Texas Tech has never led. Jackson for 3. Much needed. And for Texas Tech, their first 3-point hit. They're now 1 of 3. Gonzaga is only 0 of 1. Here's their second 3-point attempt. Now 0 of 2 above the arc.
Gonzaga is not a 3-point shooting team. Only about 15% of their points come from beyond the arc. Rivio, the big 3-point shooter, other than Morrison, nobody else is even in double figures shooting through.
Wild pass and quickly doubled was Jackson.
So you don't want to be dribbling the ball around the perimeter against the zone. You want to be attacking with the dribble. moving it around with the pass.
Good point. Shot clock is down to 8. Screen by Dora. Ross, shot clock at 1. He's got a fire, and there it goes. Nice defense by Gonzaga. That's the first turnover for Texas Tech and Bob Knight in this game.
And Bob Knight is getting up, basically asking them what they're going to do. You have to pass the ball around the zone. You want to attack with the dribble. They had some early success dribbling into the zone, but now they're not dribbling into that defense. They're sort of dribbling around it, and it's causing them to stand around.
You just saw Gonzaga has turned it over 3 times. A high arching shot by Turioff. Another rebound for Texas Tech. And Tech trails in the rebounding category by 6. Gonzaga has controlled the glass, and a whistle inside and a foul on Gonzaga.
The defense of Gonzaga and the white shirts, they're playing zone, so obviously that means they're not guarding a man, they're guarding an area, and they just don't get it around the zone. And see, Bob Knight is saying, guys, come on, what are we doing here?
Altidore Cespedes has picked up his 2nd foul, so the 2-point guards for this Gonzaga team, each with 2 fouls. Good entry pass as they get Jackson to Giles, and a rebound pulled down by Morrison. He's got 3. For 3, Morrison at the other end. And a rebound by Zeno.
Morrison is only a 32% shooter from beyond the arc. He makes big baskets, just doesn't make a very high percentage.
We got a tie and no lead changes so far in this first half. Off the door, Cespedes on Jackson.
Very, very active out on the perimeter in that zone.
Zeno on Morrison. And snaps it outside to Daryl Tora, beating 2 defenders, and they alter the shot. Here's Morrison again the other way.
Texas Tech stays in the man-to-man.
This is Earl Knight.
Now that ball went down, Kevin, but Gonzaga has sort of gotten away on offense from punching that ball inside. When you have Turioff and Batista both in the game, you may want to take a look at them before you shoot that quick perimeter jump shot.
Knight's got 8. They go to Zeno. Again, finds space inside. He's done that 3 times this afternoon. Below that free throw line in the upper part of the lane.
The defense is trying to push out on the perimeter, and so that middle has been open. Morrison said something to Batista. Batista, he's the guy who's supposed to step up and cover that play.
Batista's on top here. Usually he roams down low. And he gets his own miss and tries inside, and there is an offensive foul. Ross finding 2 inside, but Morrison has been a star again. 8 points, leading Gonzaga up by 3.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
There are the early numbers with Gonzaga leading by 3 with Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan. You came into this game thinking one way. Are you still thinking that way?
I sure am. You can see Ross and Morrison leading the way, and I thought it would be a matter of matchups. Gonzaga thus far has had the better on the inside, and with those 2 Gonzaga guards in foul trouble, Texas Tech obviously has had the better of it out on the perimeter.
They've got Rivio back in the game for Gonzaga, and a new player is in for Texas Tech. That is Siljagic. Siljagic in the middle. That is the first Texas Tech substitution we have seen in this game.
Texas Tech doesn't normally go very deep.
Dora looking for Siljagic inside and cleaned up by Turioff, who's out there. Batista, Rivio, Altidore, Cespedes, and Knight. That is the 5 on the floor for Gonzaga. Batista and quickly double. Rivio again, and Siljagic knocked it away. Batista, they say, for Gonzaga, the last to touch it. And so it will go to the Red Raiders out of the Big 12. Talked about Siljagic being in the game for the first time. Dora is in there. Zeno. Ross tries to sneak it in. Jackson remains. That's a turnover. And they go the other way with Gonzaga. And Wednesday on Survivor, the Tribes face an unforgettable showdown. Don't miss a powerful new episode of Survivor on a special night Wednesday here on CBS.
Texas Tech has now turned it over a couple of times in succession. Gonzaga really needs to take advantage.
Rivio with a good move to free himself of the defense of Jackson. Tipped in by Knight. Untouched coming off the opposite side.
And Knight has had a big game, particularly with his ability to get to the offensive boards.
Speaking of that, Gonzaga is +6 in offensive rebounding so far in this game. Knight has gone 5 of 6 shooting the ball for the Bulldogs.
Texas Tech has tried to force it inside the last couple of trips against the zone.
Zeno. 1 of 4 three-point shooting, and here is Ross. And again, another rebound for Gonzaga. And here's Knight, inside on Zeno, contorts for two. And he's given Gonzaga the biggest lead this afternoon. Timeout for Bob Knight and Texas Tech. They've never led. They trail now by 7. And Knight coming in with the game-high 12 for the Bulldogs. Looking at the Sweet 16 in this second round.
The fan sitting here switched his car and
Trace, CBS Tuesday.
Who could forget the run by Gonzaga in 99 that began it all?
Aiden to shoot, Hall, the runner! Loose ball, it goes! Shannon from the corner, and it's over! Gonzaga, the slipper still fits!
Dan Munson was the coach then. He now coaches at Minnesota, and here came Mark Few to continue the great coaching and the success of this program. We're approaching 5 minutes to play. We're in the first half. This is the Albuquerque Regional. We are in Tucson, Arizona with Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan. And a timeout taken by Texas Tech. The Red Raiders being out-rebounded and outscored by 7.
That time of year again.
Big deals for the big dance. The GM NCAA March Madness event. Score big with specially marked deals. The price you see is the price you pay.
Let's take a look as State Farm covers the court with their tournament summary.
Big wins, obviously, for Bucknell and Vermont. Now, coming out of that first timeout, Gonzaga went to a 1-3-1 zone. Texas Tech had to call a timeout. Now Gonzaga back to the matchup 2-3.
Curtis Marshall has come in for Texas Tech, their second substitution. Jackson remains. Ross with the ball right now. So Jokic inside. Dora on the baseline. This is Ross.
Boy, how many times have we seen that today? The shot clock running down. Texas Tech attempting a tough one.
Altidore Cespedes into Batista. He beat Texas Tech, so Jokic for position, and that was the key, and it's the biggest lead of Gonzaga in the first half.
They list Batista at 269 pounds, and he got himself down inside effectively. Now here's that 1-3-1 zone again. Great pass.
It was inside. Ross going for Siljagic. He's got all kinds of traffic, and he still can't get it with a couple of very close shots. Batista the rebound, Morrison the other way.
Morrison flying down the court, a bit of a force that time. Texas Tech, one of the ways you can beat a zone is to get down before it gets set, and that's exactly what Jackson does.
And that's a place where Zeno has been scoring. That's where everybody has been scoring for Tech, and 8 points for Jackson. 12 by Knight, leading all scores for Gonzaga.
Well, you know, Knight, that's an interesting, if you play having Texas Tech game, you figure the story's going to be Bob Knight or Pat Knight, but today it's Earl Knight from Gonzaga. 6 of 7, 12 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists.
3.5 to play in the half. Morrison. Quick rebound by Knight and calls a timeout. Kept his balance, kept his poise, and that is what we have seen from Gonzaga in this tournament so far. With 9 offensive rebounds, they lead the game by 7.
Wrong.
Miller, good call.
We've had a tie, no lead changes in this first half so far. Gonzaga has led by as many as 9. Texas Tech and Bob Knight, 44% from the floor. Gonzaga has gone 14 of 28, 50% shooting. 3:29 to play, the leading scorer Knight with 12.
Gonzaga has gotten the better shots. You can see right there, 9 assists with 14 baskets. They've been able to punch the ball inside.
Batista, they try to pinch in Mallon with another offensive rebound. And that is what has destroyed the Red Raiders this afternoon.
But the key is getting that ball inside to a guy like Batista who's going to make a move to the basket. The defense has to come and help. The rotation isn't there. Somebody's got to drop down and block out. They haven't done it very well in the first half.
Lawson, Jackson, Dora, and Giles have played every minute so far. Now
they,
Marshall.
They switch back to the 2-3 zone. Trying to confuse Texas Tech, giving them different looks.
Nice little crossover by Jackson, but can't hit it. Batista with the rebound. Plus 13 overall rebounds for Gonzaga over Texas Tech. Morris in for three. And that's the first killer above the arc for Gonzaga this afternoon. And it gives the Bulldogs their biggest lead.
I think he's a much better three-point shooter off the dribble, Kevin, than standing there shooting it.
Gonzaga is riding an 11-2 run right now.
So you got to move the ball. The ball's got to go from side to side and in and out. You can't do a lot of dribbling. Ross, that's the kind of dribbling you want to do, that attacking dribble.
And again, underneath that free throw line in that lane.
And this lead with Gonzaga gives them a chance to get Rivio and his two fouls out of the game. And that may be important later on.
Morrison with 11. And Batista's got four.
That was a good double team that time. You know, Batista has to make a couple of moves and shoot a short jump shot. He's not as good as when he's doing those little hooks with his back to the basket.
Ross has put in nine.
Well, he's decided he's going to put him on his back and carry him. That is just a great penetrating move in the lane. We haven't had anything from Dora and Giles, basically. It's been Ross, Jackson, and Zeno.
Ross now the first Texas Tech Red Raider in double figures. Timeout.
Vertical, 27 inches.
Ball velocity,
119.
Cleat size,
11 and a half.
Let's move, man. Let's go! Go!
Baseball. Right down to the smallest details. MLB 2006. Nothing is more true to the game. Rated E for everyone.
Plus 7 in offensive rebounds and plus 8 in second chance points. Pretty important categories for Gonzaga.
And that's the place where Bob Knight and the Texas Tech Red Raiders knew that they were going to have to play well on the inside. Gonzaga big and powerful in there. Now Texas Tech needs to turn it up on the defensive end, not only getting those defensive rebounds, but they'd really like to force some turnovers and be able to beat that defense down the court.
Allen, there's a screen by Turioff, and a pass from Morrison to Turioff, who had it wiped away inside. And a pretty good rejection that was turned in by Giles, who picks up his second personal foul on a timeout with 1:25 to play.
Enjoy the countdown to the Final Four with CBS Sports and Coca-Cola.
The Gonzaga muscle has been evident in the first half, just really scrambling around the boards, keeping the ball alive, then securing those rebounds. Knight has been the big player in terms of rebounding the ball and conversions for Gonzaga, and that's why the Zags lead it by 8. The rebounding numbers, that they do not lie.
Tony Turioff at the free throw line. He had 16 free throw attempts the other afternoon against Winthrop, and that is his first attempt today. He's got 7 points and 7 rebounds.
And Gonzaga, one of those teams, they make more free throws than their opponents attempt, and that is generally a pretty good formula for success, although Turioff only makes 1 of 2.
Gonzaga has led by as many as 12. Texas Tech has never led. We've had no lead changes, obviously, and 1 tie that was early on.
Well, Gonzaga again trying that trapping 1-3-1.
And Daryl Dora, he's only got a couple points. Morrison tonight.
Been a problem. Texas Tech has gotten nothing from its inside guys.
Morrison, great pass. And Turioff, they collapse on him with Dora climbing his back. And Turioff again go to the free throw line for Gonzaga.
Morrison, we talk about his shooting numbers. He's also a pretty good passer. Comes in with 86 assists on the season. Recognizes the defense coming to him. Finds his open teammate, Turioff.
So here is Roni Turioff for Martinica Senior, the West Coast Conference Player of the Year. Coming up in the singular at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, and Sports Illustrated Seth Davis will mix it up in tourney time. They'll also take a look at Utah's Andrew Bogut, who will play in game two here in Tucson. And give you the latest singular Naismith watch. That's all coming up on the singular at the half.
Boy, Gonzaga, they have attempted now 11 free throws in the game, but Mark Few's troops, a 75% free throw shooting team, they have missed a fair number. So they're ahead, but they could be even further ahead if they're converting the free throws, and they are not.
Mallon picked up the foul for Gonzaga. And at the free throw line is Demir Soljagic. He is a freshman, ironically enough, from Tucson, Arizona. He was born in the former Yugoslavia. He was schooled in Austria until he was in sixth grade. And came to the U.S.
Texas Tech stays in the man-to-man. About a 20-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
There's a turnover. Ross. And in the lane. Nice rebound. Nice pickup by Knight. The shot clock and the game clock are one. Knight has grabbed five rebounds, and here is a three by Morrison, and a rebound by Ross, and rips it away from Mallon, and here come the Red Raiders. Trying to make some kind of statement here as the first half winds down.
Kevin, they had a four-on-one break, but three of the guys all got clustered on in one place on the opposite side of the floor from Ross. He had nobody to throw the ball to, enabled Gonzaga to get back.
Jackson, a screen by Dora. Quickly there, Altidore Cespedes. That's a three by Marshall, missed it all. Mallon gets it. And here comes Morrison, which takes us to halftime. Morrison with 11 points against Bob Knight's Red Raiders of Texas Tech. The longest current winning streak in college basketball. 13 straight wins by Gonzaga. That's the end of our first half. We'll send you to Greg Gumbel in New York after these messages and a word from your local CBS station.
Sponsored by Singular, raising the bar.
Welcome once again to our New York studios and Singular at the half, everyone. I'm Greg Gumbel. After 20 minutes of play in Tucson, Gonzaga leading the Red Raiders at Texas Tech 38-29. I am joined by Clark Kellogg and Seth Davis of Sports Illustrated, who are about to enlighten you on what they saw in the first half of significance.
Well, what we thought was going to happen happened, actually. Gonzaga able to control things in the paint area. Adam Morrison had a big half, but Earl Knight also did a terrific job in kind of a complimentary role. He would be our Jermaine Mopa-Gila, the guy who steps up out of nowhere to produce numbers greater than what he normally does. He did it in transition off the board, knocked down a perimeter shot. He scored 12 points. He only averages 7 a game on the season. He also has already picked off 5 rebounds, so a terrific game in the first half by Knight.
Let's go to our Jermaine Mopa-Gila.
I just like saying Mopa-Gila, and Texas Tech could use a Mopa-Gila right now from Devon Giles. Only 2 points and 1 rebound in the first half, not showing up the way he did against UCLA. And really, their only offense is coming as usual from Ronald Ross. He's got 11 points, but it's taken him 12 shots. He's 0 for 3 from 3-point range. Gonzaga sitting back in that 2-3 zone. At some point, you got to make 3-pointers. Unfortunately, Texas Tech, that is not their strength, and it's really hard to see how they're going to come back and win this one.
All right, guys, we remind you that coming up next here on CBS, Pacific, fresh off its victory over Pitt, will challenge Washington, the top seed in the Albuquerque bracket, and Utah squares off with number 3 Oklahoma in Austin regional action. Now, in advancing past UTEP on Thursday, Utah was led as usual by its 7-foot, 245-pound center, Andrew Bogut. He hit 24 points, 11 rebounds, and 4 blocks. What's unusual, however, is the journey this worldly sophomore has taken in becoming one of the nation's leading players.
He's a young man who has great pride in his Croatian heritage. Was born and raised in Australia, has pride in Australia. When he at 16 years old, was cut from his state team. And I think that really inspired him. He was going to make sure that that didn't happen again.
He's obviously came from a unique background, and he's had his ups and downs. And I think that's why he succeeds today, is because of all the difficulties he's had to face coming up to this point.
Just enjoyed basketball, shot a rusty little hoop at my dad's own business workshop in Melbourne, and just loved it and went from there. Got cut from a lot of teams as a young kid and struggled to find my place in the basketball world, as to say, and then decided to really take it seriously as a 15, 16 year old, and just worked my butt off for a year straight, every day nonstop, and then got to where I am now.
I think for Andrew, it must have been hard first few years. I think he was already following his dream when he came to America. So he was basically a little bit more prepared from my side for his future than my parents. My parents just brought me into another country, which was very difficult. When he started basketball, yeah, I knew from day one, I think he was about 11, that he's gonna be very, very good. I used to tell him actually that he's gonna play against the guys in NBA, and he used to laugh at me, he used to call me stupid sometimes.
Step your game up.
What you waiting for?
Step your game up.
Playing against Tim Duncan and all the best in the world, you know, from Lithuania and so on, just gave me so much confidence, because I think I held my own and played pretty well against those guys. And then coming back to college, I knew that I'm playing against kids my age and guys that are my strength, so I knew it'd be a good situation for me.
He's a guy that averaged darn near a double-double over there during his Olympic experience. I think that really was kind of the final piece for him, confidence-wise, to know that his future is very bright and it's right now.
You're a superstar.
Definitely, I gotta enjoy it, man. It's part of being an athlete and part of being a good athlete. I think I gotta enjoy all the media stuff like that. It's been great to this point and just having fun with them too.
Same old Andrew. Hasn't changed him one bit, which is great. But that's how we are. That's our families. We don't change for popularity or money. I think sometimes for Andrew it's overwhelming. I think we might even put him under a certain amount of pressure, because we just love him so much and we care for him and we want him to do well. But he's proven whatever he has to prove already to us. There's no more need for proof.
The big guy seems to do pretty well, whoever he goes up against. How does Oklahoma match up against Mr. Bogut?
Well, they've got two big guys inside. Not as tall as Andrew Bogut, but wide and strong Taj Gray and Kevin Bookout. And Calvin Sampson's teams do a nice job of trapping and doubling up on the post. I think Bogut will still get his numbers, but he's going to need help from his teammates, because I think they'll sit in his lap and double-team him an awful lot today.
You know, UTEP double-teamed and triple-teamed Bogut, but they were doing it with guys who were 6'6 and 6'7, the guys that Clark was just talking about. Don't forget about Longar. Longar may be coming off the bench with a lot of size. I just don't think that Utah will get enough production from their perimeter guys to pull this one out.
All right, guys, it's time now to look at another candidate for this year's Naismith Trophy, presented by Singular Wireless. Clark?
We call him the miniature power pack playmaker, Nate Robinson, the point guard for the Washington Huskies, in the top four in assists and steals, led his team in scoring. In today's matchup against Pacific, he's got to be the catalyst at both ends of the floor.
All right, Clark, remember, you can still play Naismith Trivia for a shot at a million. Text PLAY to 26222 on your wireless phone. 20 questions, 20 chances to win a trip to the 2005 NCAA Men's Final Four, and a shot at a million. Up next, Seth and Clark go one-on-one in a round of tourney time when Singular at the Half continues after this.
Gonzaga has never trailed, and they've led by as many as 12. Monday on CBS, Tony Hawk plays a skateboarding legend, but he won't survive a new CSI Miami. Now the clues to his disappearance are in a video game. Don't miss a new episode Monday here on CBS. The West Coast Conference champion Gonzaga Bulldogs and the Red Raiders from Texas Tech. You're watching CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship.
Chevy. And by Miller.
We're in Tucson, the Albuquerque bracket, Texas Tech and Gonzaga, with Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan. Thank you for joining us. Now becomes a very interesting juncture of this game, adjustments.
Boy, it sure does. And I think that the onus, if that's the right word, falls on Bob Knight and his coaching staff at this point, because Gonzaga has made some pretty good adjustments throughout the first half. I think Texas Tech is going to have to figure out a way to handle that matchup zone defense. And they did well early when they were penetrating with the basketball late, too much standing around.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. It's going to be a very interesting second half. There's no doubt about that. Let's take a look at some of the numbers for Roni Turiaf.
But Turioff is one of the things that distinguished the game was the fact that Gonzaga was able to punch the ball inside. Turioff with three field goals, doing a nice job keeping the ball live on the rim. He was only 1 for 4 from the free throw line, but I thought his energy was a big key in the first half for Gonzaga. Conversely, the inside players from Texas Tech, as you look at Turioff's numbers, the three guys that Bob Knight played on the inside, Giles, Gora, and Soyagic, among them, only 4 points and three rebounds.
There's some of the halftime numbers. We begin the second half. Earl Knight leads all scorers. Morrison, Rivio playing with two fouls. He's got the ball right now. Batista and Turioff with the ball against Daryl Dora. Nice feed to Morrison. Batista with the offensive rebound. Another rebound for the Bulldogs.
And again, you get Turioff the ball inside. It draws the defense. Morrison open. Then somebody's got to come and cover him. And Batista is the guy they leave alone.
Ross Jackson, Zeno, Dora, and Giles beginning the second half for the Red Raiders. A dive inside. Zeno can't get it. And here comes Rivio. Knight never breaks. Tried. What a play coming off the wing.
Now, Knight is a guy who was 6 of 7 shooting the ball in the first half. He's now got 14 points, Kevin.
This is the biggest Gonzaga lead this afternoon. With Jackson finding Ross, the former walk-on, working on Rivio. Open, Daryl Dora. And they need him to score.
That's a big basket. That's a place from where Texas Tech has had no offense. That little jumper along the baseline has been available, but Giles and Dora have not been able to knock it down.
Batista again with Giles defending, and he pops it away, and it's a pickup by Zeno, and it's a 2-on-1. Rivio defending, and Jackson finishing.
And that's the way you beat the zone defense. You get down the court before the defense can get set. Rivio backed off because he's got those two fouls.
Batista uncovered, launching a three, Dora the rebound.
You know, I think if I'm Mark Few, I'm going to come out on the court and grab Batista, except that he's 270 pounds. That's not the shot that you want. Get the big guy down on the inside.
And going inside for that mid-range jump shot, which has been key for the Red Raiders today. Ross now picked up by Morrison.
And that's a great tip out on the inside by Giles. If you can't get the ball away from those big guys, tip it out, let your guards get it.
Zeno, Ross, a screen by Giles. That opened the door, and a big-time three.
Neither team relies very heavily on the three-point shot, but if you're going to get a three for Texas Tech, Ross is a guy who can get it.
A 7-0 run by Texas Tech. Here's Morrison over Zeno.
Hard to get a big run against Gonzaga when you've got a scoring machine like Morrison playing for the guys in white.
Morrison's got 13, game high 14 for Knight, leading Gonzaga. 14, game high for Ross, leading Texas Tech. Zeno with Batista defending. And a pass to Giles and a Knight foul for Gonzaga. His second.
Kevin, we talked before the game about what Ronald Ross does without the basketball. Just finds an open spot against the zone, gets himself ready to go. Oklahoma's Kelvin Sampson said yesterday he thought Ronald Ross was the best player in the Big 12 without the ball. And that's what we've seen so far in this tournament.
Texas Tech, the 6th seed. And here is Giles. And Gonzaga with the ball, the 3 seed. This is the Albuquerque Regional. The winner will play the winner of West Virginia Wake Forest. And right now, it looks like Gonzaga is trying to make a move in that direction with a good pass, Morrison to Batista.
Boy, Batista just does a great job running it to the block, and Morrison finds him. The guys who are willing to run down the court can score a lot of points.
Texas Tech beat UCLA by 12 on Thursday. Wide open door again. Hit from the opposite baseline the last time. Knocks in a 2-point from the left baseline that time.
Gonzaga doing a better job covering that dribble penetration.
A Gonzaga turnover. The pace is much different to begin this second half. Zeno. Jackson. And he'll put up a three. And bury it from outside.
He's also an excellent three-point shooter, and I think the quicker pace actually may work in favor of Texas Tech. They want to get down and play before the Gonzaga defense can get set.
Texas Tech has hit 3 three-point shots, and Gonzaga just 1.
And this is where Gonzaga has been the best in the half-court offense, using their bigger guys.
Morrison with authority down the lane.
That's a heck of a move. You see that little hesitation, Kevin, before he turned the corner? He's much, much better with the ball than you think just looking at it.
It's a 6'9 kid, too, with those kind of moves. That extra gear, as you talk about. Texas Tech at 21-10. Zeno, Jackson.
He had Ross open in the corner and missed it.
Now Ross tries to get by Morrison, does get by Turioff, and goes inside and draws the Gonzaga foul. So we see Jackson on one end and Morrison on the other. The pace is starting to pick up in Tucson in this round of 32.
Simon Green
had zero scholarship offers coming out of high school. The folks at Texas Tech saw him. They thought he was a pretty good player. They didn't have a scholarship for him. So Pat Knight, the assistant at Texas Tech, actually called people he knew from small colleges and junior colleges, tried to get him to take this kid. Nobody would, so they told him, well, you can come to Texas Tech and play. We don't have a scholarship for you. And he has, as you mentioned, just turned out to be a great player, all conference in the Big 12.
And he was a great high school player, too. He played for a team that was a three-time state champion, and he was the Gatorade High School Player of the Year in New Mexico. Like you said, drew very little interest, but now he is the core of Bob Knight's NCAA Texas Tech team. Mallon has come in for Batista for Gonzaga, and that is the only Bulldog change. And surveying Texas Tech, they have stayed the same out of the break. We're 5 minutes into the second half. Texas Tech has never led. We've had one tie at two. Turioff with the left hand over Giles.
What a great move. The key to that move was getting the ball past Ronald Ross, who was in great position to make a steal. So it's strength and quickness by Turioff. A marvelous inside move.
Running out with 9 points and 9 rebounds. And here comes Texas Tech. They are 46% from the field shooting today. Zeno, wide open, is Ross for three. Good offensive rebound by Dora, following well inside.
And Dora has scored 6 points in this half after being very quiet in the first half, and that, I think, is going to be important. Texas Tech needs to get some offense from those inside guys, particularly on those second-chance opportunities. Mm-hmm.
Gonzaga shooting 52% from the floor for the game. Turioff again against Dora. Oh, and he was double-teamed. Looked like Jackson may have snuck a hand in there. And I think Dora picks up the foul. He does. It's his third. He has the most of any player on the floor and in the game. And coming up, second round games. Pacific against the top seed Huskies of Washington from the Pac-10. And then it'll be Utah against Oklahoma. That'll be a beauty, and most of you will see that in the Austin Regional here in Tucson.
Very often mentioned, only one of four from the free throw line in the first half.
Well, here is a kid. He's a senior. He is so much... Dan enjoyed the college experience.
Well, he really has. He's made himself. He's known by his first name up in the Gonzaga area, up there in Spokane. Everybody knows who Roni is, knows all the secretaries, knows all the janitors, knows all the professors, goes to the soccer games, goes to the baseball games. He's one of the big cheerleaders. He's a guy that just has really, as you mentioned, he's the, one of the poster children for the enjoyment of the college experience, the other one being my son.
Jackson with it, and he's got 13. Ross with it, and he's got a Texas Tech high 15 points. Dora over Mallon. Morrison got a hand on it, but vacuumed in by Giles, who gets a big two for Texas Tech.
And Texas Tech, Kevin, really doing a nice job hanging around, closing that gap.
Gonzaga coming into this game 26-4, and riding a 13-game winning streak, the longest of any team in this tournament. Turioff to Rivio. Oh, and he hits a three. He was only 2 of 10 shooting in the game against Winthrop on Thursday, and comes up with a three there. He is 1 of 4 this afternoon.
And that is his, obviously his first field goal of any kind, but his first three. He is a tremendous three-point shooter. And that's going to open things up on the inside if he can convert with some consistency.
It's Jackson from close range and climbs over Mallon to get the basket. And he now has put in 15. He is 6 of 8 from the floor.
And there's that quick attack on the dribble penetration that has worked so successfully at times for Texas Tech in this ballgame.
There's Mallon, and guarded by Giles. lost it. Another turnover, and that has been a problem in the second half for Gonzaga.
Boy, a lot of standing around by the Bulldogs on the offensive end.
Sino.
And you know, when you turn it over, it's hard to get back and get your defense set, and Texas Tech taking advantage, and there's another turnover.
That's the third in the second half for the Bulldogs, and numbers now for Texas Tech, and Ross has brought Texas Tech back to within two after trailing by 13 points moments ago. The Red Raiders are back in business. They're on a 6-0 run. Their defense on one end, some sharp shooting on the other. And a timeout in Tucson.
With a great tasting, less filling Miller Lite. Miller, good call.
Bob Knight has strung together four consecutive 20-win seasons at Texas Tech, and this is the second straight NCAA tournament appearance for his Red Raiders.
And for better or for worse, even with a coach with the pedigree that Bob Knight has and the job that he's done throughout his career, you're judged by what you do in the NCAA tournament. As you saw there, lately, his teams have not advanced to the Sweet 16, and there's another turnover by Gonzaga, and that has really been one of the big keys to the second half. Texas Tech is doing a much better job moving the ball, but it's Gonzaga turnovers that have really hurt Mark Few's team.
Mallon made the illegal screen, picks up the foul. Three straight turnovers for Gonzaga. Knight has made adjustments in his team to within two. Down by 13, Texas Tech has clawed their way back to within two.
Better ball movement on offense, less unproductive dribbling. They've been getting some scoring from the corners from Dora, and they've been forcing turnovers and getting offensive rebounds, you know, and plus the game's a lot easier when the ball's going in the basket.
And shooting 67% is Texas Tech in the second half, but Gonzaga is shooting 70%. They go inside Jackson, trying to find Giles, torn away by Morrison. Turioff back in the game. Mallon is on the bench.
Gonzaga adjusts to that 1-3-1 zone.
Morrison the miss. Rebound by Dora, and Giles is down. Injured and not getting up quickly at all.
May have turned an ankle in there. Giles is the guy that lost the ball the last time on that possession, on the previous possession against the 1-3-1 zone.
One of the other things, too, Dan, about Texas Tech's play in this game, and it's been kind of slow in developing as we take a look at where that possible. Yeah, I think he may have turned that ankle.
Well, he just got knocked down. He was barely in the play at all. You just saw him come in there and bounce off and go down.
But the efficiency of Texas Tech's game, 14 assists and just four turnovers.
This is an interesting Texas Tech team. I was talking to Pat Knight before the game, and he was telling me that the coaching staff really has a hard time figuring them out, that sometimes they play well, sometimes they don't. But one of the things that throughout the season, when they would get behind, they would not come back in the game. But Pat felt like maybe the Iowa State game in the Big 12 tournament might have been a turning point, because they did get behind in that game, but nonetheless rallied. And today you have another instance. They were down by 13 in this half, and yet they have come back and once again have a chance to tie or lead.
Here comes Jackson. Ronald Ross has a game high 17 points for Texas Tech. 15 for Morrison leading the Bulldogs. Here's Zeno. Left open is Dora. And a rebound by Rivier. He'll put up a three. Nailed the last one. Misses that one. Ross with a Texas Tech rebound.
See, I don't know that that's the shot they need. Gonzaga had great success going inside. They need to try to go inside.
Ross from point blank range gets his miss. And now the deficit on the glass for Texas Tech is 7. They trail Gonzaga by 7 rebounds in this game.
Hawkins, the football player, got his hand on that one. He's got the ball now.
Hawkins in for the first time. He's a senior from Grapevine, Texas. We're in number 50 and patrolling down low. Oh, nice pass. Dora inside. And it was claimed by Zeno. And he'll go to the line. Near the end of today's game, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. And to honor their determination and outstanding play, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. Chevy, an American Revolution, with Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan. Turioff just picked up his third foul for Gonzaga. Geno can tie with this trip to the line. Hits his first right there. We've had one previous tie, and that was at 2. Knight will leave, and Altidore Cespedes will come in, smaller player for Gonzaga.
I think at this point in the game, Turioff is staying in the game because Mark Few wants to get some production offensively on the inside.
So basically, two point guards, Gravio and Altidore Cespedes in the backcourt. Both can handle the ball. Screen by Batista. Pick and roll. He goes inside.
Boy, he just does not finish that ball with any strength at all. He sort of backed away. You got to power that ball to the basket when you're as big as Batista.
Ross in on Morrison. Here's Dora in on Turioff. He's playing with the three fouls and maybe a little bit hesitant on defense. Regardless, it is a 9-0 run as Dora hits the basket, and Texas Tech has their first lead today of 1.
Hesitant or not, Dora has had a big second half offensively. That inside scoring, I think, has really been a significant factor.
We've had a 14-point turnaround in this second half and in the first 10 and a half minutes of it. Dora's been a big reason why he's got 10 points for the game.
Well, they only had 2 points in the first half. They were getting no inside scoring, but Dora that time knows Turioff is guarding him, knows Turioff has to be careful, makes a nice move. And look, you look at Gonzaga. It's been a while since they've scored. They're turning the ball over, and that plays right into the hands of Texas Tech. And when you're Texas Tech and you start scoring with some consistency, you start playing with a lot more confidence.
Morrison rejected by Giles. Got the loose ball. Shot clock continues to tick, and a foul inside. So the perseverance of Morrison pays off, and the foul will go on Giles of Texas Tech, who picks up number 3.
Morrison, really a great effort. And when you're a guy that can score as well as he can score, you really need to have the ball in your hands when your team is struggling, and he just went and got it.
Morrison hits.
He's a 76% free throw shooter. You see Devon Giles. He struggled after a Giles has, that is, after a great game the other night. Boy, Gonzaga's free throw shooting. They're only 5 of 10 in the first half, and they continue to struggle now. 7 of 14.
Tech is 4 of 9 at the free throw line.
I mentioned earlier, both these teams well over 70% as teams shooting free throws. Here's that zone defense, the 2-3 matchup.
Texas Tech has gone 3 of 9 shooting the three ball this afternoon. Shot clock at 9. Altidore rejects Zeno inside.
And Turioff is a guy, I don't know that he really understands how to be careful. That was a great play. And Gonzaga gets a break because the ball bounces off the foot of Zeno. He comes after that with his left hand, blocks it right off Zeno's foot. That's an outstanding play, particularly for a guy with 3 fouls.
Gonzaga with the ball, and above the arc is Rivio. They've gone 2 of 9 shooting the 3. Now 2 of 10. Nice offensive rebound by Batista. Hounded by Ross. Saved by Altidore Cespedes, who steps out of bounds. The winner of this Texas Tech-Gonzaga game will play the winner of West Virginia and Wake Forest. This is the Albuquerque Regional. These are tomorrow games in the second round. Washington Pacific with a nice win, Pacific over Pittsburgh.
And that Georgia Tech-Louisville matchup shapes up to be a really, really good one. You know, that ball was off Ross going out of bounds. Altidore Cespedes didn't need to go after it.
And Altidore Cespedes is out. Earl Knight is back in the game for Gonzaga. Chiseling his way inside is Ross. Picks up the loose ball. Dora.
Batista just couldn't handle that rebound. Great hustle there by Ross.
Jarius Jackson. Rivio knocked it away. The outlet was deflected. And Dora comes up with it 3-on-2. Dumping inside to Childs. And Texas Tech has got their biggest lead.
Texas Tech has done a nice job forcing turnovers. A good scramble back by the Red Raiders. Knocking that outlet pass down. Gonzaga had a basket. They knocked the ball away.
Turioff against Dora. Zeno lunging in. Picking up a foul. What a comeback. A 15-point turnaround in this second half. And Texas Tech with their biggest lead of two. Trailing by nine at halftime, Texas Tech now is up by two with Dan Bonner. This is Kevin Harlan. We're in Tucson. Let's talk about differences in the offense with Texas Tech.
Well, one of the things they've gotten is a third scorer all of a sudden. In fact, the fourth scorer, Zeno, did a nice job in the first half, but it's been Deradora in the second half. He only had 2 points at halftime. He's got 10 now. Has been very effective inside, although now he's got four fouls.
Yeah, just picked one up. Here's Turioff continuing to fight. Knight lost it. Inside claim by Zeno. This game has had two ties and a lead change. Gonzaga led earlier in this half by 13. And as you can see, Tech up by two.
Boy, and you just can't force it on the inside. If you've got the opening take, now there's Dora we just talked about. I mean, this is the outside jumper. And one of the reasons why Gonzaga is struggling on offense is Texas Tech has done a great job defending Rivio. The point guard just has had a very difficult time getting Gonzaga in their offensive sets.
Here's Knight, Morrison, off Batista and Rivio. That's the five for Gonzaga on the floor. Morrison tries to squeak inside and get his miss and puts it in and ties the game at 57.
When Morrison telling the referee he thought he was fouled, he's getting a little angry. I'm still talking to the referee.
So Jackson and Ross are in the Texas Tech backcourt. Dora is in there. Giles with the ball. Zeno remains. That sets the lineups out of that break. We've got some players and foul problems. Dora, number one, has got four. He's on the floor right now for the Red Raiders. Wheeling around and through the lane is Zeno. And now to Dora. He's missed two in a row. Batista with the rebound. Zeno's also got four fouls for Texas Tech, so they've got some issues right now. Here comes Ross, and he goes in tonight. And a travel on Ronald Ross.
Well, Bob Knight is upset with that call, but Ross got away with a carry. When he stole the ball gets caught up on his shoulder. He actually took a couple of steps. Watch this right here before he gets the dribble down. And Knight really does a nice job staying away. Ross just lost his balance. But that shows you the aggressiveness on defense of Texas Tech. And that aggressiveness has really disrupted the Gonzaga offense.
Gonzaga shooting 46% from the floor. Morrison doubled. Foul. Boy, he's got 20 points and 8 rebounds. And a big shot right there.
And is he pumped up or what? Not him. Bob Knight very unhappy with what's going on. But Morrison gets the ball down low. He's going against Ross. A 6-inch height advantage. He waits till the double team leaves and then goes up and draws the foul.
Ross picks up his first. Morrison at the free throw line. He's coming off a 27-point performance in the win over Winthrop on Thursday. Now he's got 21.
Boy, a couple of big scores by Morrison.
Texas Tech is shooting 46% from the floor. They've got it with Ross. Zeno.
Zeno's been quiet in the second half. Oh, now who'd they get? Giles?
They did. Giles down below was pushing Batista out of that spot. That's the 15 foul. And Giles has four and Dora now with four.
When this really some problems for Texas Tech on the inside, and Gonzaga, even though they haven't been real efficient going inside, they've been able to draw some fouls. Now Zeno matched up against Morrison.
It's Morrison over Zeno.
It doesn't make any difference. Morrison against anybody. He's got a 3-inch height advantage over Zeno. Zeno's got four fouls. Morrison just smells it now.
It's been only Morrison over the last 8 minutes for Gonzaga. Dora to Giles to Ross.
Oh, what a block!
Connected, and they're going to count it. Turioff got up there. So count it for two and checked it within three.
That's the kind of ball movement that Texas Tech is looking for. Now, you're allowed to hit the ball in college basketball once it hits the backboard, but not if it's in its downward flight, and that was the call right there. The ball hit the board, the official ruled it was in its downward flight. Now, Texas Tech has to dig in defensively, find some way to defend this guy.
Rivio and Morrison, Zeno defending. Texas Tech is minus 11 in rebounding. They got a 3-on-2. Jackson to Zeno to Ross with a couple of deceptive fakes. And Batista digs his way in, and a whistle and a Texas Tech foul. Ross picks up number 2.
Well, when you get an opportunity like this, you really need to convert. Jackson coming down, makes the pass. Now, maybe he's got to shoot the ball, Zeno. Ross actually loses the ball on his leg, and that allows the Gonzaga defense to get there. Look to me like Zeno just powers the ball to the goal, maybe draws a foul.
Of course, it's sort of easy sitting over here. Isn't it always? Morrison. Pribio for 3.
See, and that's the shot that has not been there for either game in this tournament for Rivio. I think if I was Texas Tech, I'd sort of drop down off him and make it harder inside.
They let Zeno fire. Batista short on the defense.
And that's the place on the court. That's the spot on the court. That mid-range jump shot on the baseline on either side that Gonzaga's had a tough time covering in this half. And Texas Tech has made them with pretty good frequency.
Yoni Turioff working on Dora Morrison for 3 over Zeno. Batista with the big offensive rebound. Now what's he going to do with it? Hort screws one up. It's Morrison who taps it in.
Boy, Batista, that's a big rebound. What a break for Gonzaga after he misses that Morrison just stays after.
Morrison has the last 10 points for Gonzaga.
Back to that matchup zone.
Lost to Jackson. Jackson knocks down Rivio, no call.
Well, you know, if you're Jackson, you make that move and you feel that guy fall down. You don't wait for the whistle. You just keep playing. And so he created an opening and knocked it in.
2.5 to play. Turioff. Across the lane, and Dora was there defending and fouls him. We take a break in a tight game. With the Morrison family watching, let's check the CBS Sportsline stat of the game for complete NCAA tournament coverage at CBSSportsline.com. Father John, the sister Sarah, and Mother Wanda there in the middle.
And they have witnessed some performance today, as have we all. Morrison. That's amazing. 14 of the 26 points in the second half scored by Morrison. Most of those here in this most recent stretch. And he's done it in a variety of ways. Driving to the basket, tip-ins. Turioff struggling from the free throw line.
Leading score, 25 for Morrison, 17 for Jackson, and 19 for Ross, leading Texas Tech. And Roney at the line. Roney is out there. Turioff with Batista and Knight. Rivio and Morrison. That's the 5 for Gonzaga with 2:27 to play. Jackson and Ross for Texas Tech. Zeno and Dora and Giles for the Red Raiders.
And if Gonzaga ends up losing this game, they're not going to have to look any further than the free throw line to determine the cause of their problems. Now 9 for 17.
Zeno is making a move and hits a hand check on Morrison.
But that's only the 5th team foul against Gonzaga. Zeno trying to take advantage. Again, Morrison is quicker than you think he is. That long, lanky, 6'9" frame. You just don't think he could move his feet quickly, but he can, although that time, Zeno beat him.
Morrison picked up his first foul. Zeno's got 3 fouls, 4 on Dora, 4 on Giles for Texas Tech. And here comes Jackson. Giles, Ross.
Well, Giles not even looking to score inside. He got that ball inside. He wasn't even ready to shoot it, had to pass it back out.
Crossover by Jackson. Slipping inside, Giles against Turioff. And a foul, and the pass came from on top, and Dora.
And Giles was ready that time. That was a great job getting positioned down on the inside. Very little the defender can do when the offensive guy catches the ball in that kind of position. And Giles going to the line for 2 is an 82% free throw shooter.
Turioff is the only Gonzaga player with 4 personal fouls. And the free throw shooting is 5 of 10 for Texas Tech. They changed the foul and put it on Batista. So Turnoff is at 3 still.
Well, that's a nice job by Giles, particularly when you're a big guy and you shoot free throws that well. You get yourself inside at the end of the game. You know nobody's going to back off. You're going to get to the free throw line.
Rybiel with it, covered by Jackson.
And Zeno trying to deny the ball to Morrison.
Turion quickly doubled. Trying to get out of a straight jacket and takes.
See, that's a play where Jackson backed off a little bit, went back to Rybiel to try to cover him. Good recognition by Turion.
Dora to Zeno. And for the lead from Ross.
What a play. The inside penetration and then the wide open look from the baseline.
I've been everywhere. Tech very efficient this afternoon, 18 assists on 7 turnovers.
And that was a great job with the penetration on the inside. The zone collapses, and Ross has been doing a wonderful job finding open spots. And this is a situation, as you look at that game reset, where Gonzaga, I think it's almost a must-score. Texas Tech, an outstanding free-throw shooting team.
No fouls to give either way. Turioff, all kinds of hands grabbing at that ball.
Monkfew obviously wants the ball to go inside. Bob Knight's guys dropped down defensively very effectively. And remember, Gonzaga, even though they come into this game, a very fine free throw shooting team, shooting almost 75% of a team, only 9 for 17 today. And this is a one-on-one opportunity. Oh, that's off.
Way off. Tech got the ball and got the lead as Bobby Knight is trying to get back to the Sweet 16 for the first time in a long time.
Now, if you're Gonzaga, you do not have to foul. You've got plenty of time. You've got to play good defense. Make sure you get the defensive rebound when the shot goes.
Well, Zeno is up high, and they want him to get down low, and Jackson has to take it himself.
It's a foul.
And it's on Gonzaga. Turioff was reaching in. Batista was there as well. It's on Batista for the third time.
And Jackson with that penetration has just done an outstanding job the entire game. Takes the ball hard to the basket. And Jackson, another one of those guys, we talked about their free throw shooting ability, 82% free throw shooting. Only 1 of 3 on the afternoon, however. Well, I'm telling you, these Texas Tech guys have just made plays in the second half. They were down 13, and they have battled back. Now, plenty of time for Gonzaga.
Timeout Gonzaga. Shot clock obviously off, 19.5 to play. Gonzaga is out of timeouts. And they trail Bob Knight and Texas Tech by 2.
Yeah, I have a little attitude.
$5. Others charge $35 or more. Sprint PCS. Now that's better.
That is our game reset.
And obviously Gonzaga with the ball. They have 19 and a half seconds. And the key for Gonzaga is here, since they're the team that's down, they can't run most of those 19 seconds off the clock before they shoot it, because if they miss, they have to be able to get a rebound or foul. I think if I'm Gonzaga, what I want to have happen here is eventually the ball end up in Morrison's hands relatively quickly. Maybe a screen for him coming off the dribble. I think he's a better shooter coming off the dribble than standing still.
Screened by Turioff for 3 in the lead. Morrison with the miss. And it's Texas Tech's ball. With 10.8 and a timeout taken by the Red Raiders, who have come back from a 13-point second half deficit to take a lead in a 15-point turnaround. Let's watch Morrison again.
And this is exactly what we were talking about. Morrison has the ball coming off the screen, well defended. We've seen him make that shot earlier in this tournament. And Giles, who has really struggled, gets the rebound and is able to call timeout. And the reaction of the Texas Tech bench, that is a tremendous play by Giles.
As we said before, it's been a while for Bob Knight since he has made a trip to the Sweet 16. As you take a look at possession arrow. And Tech up by two with just under 11 seconds to play.
That's what we're talking about with Bob Knight and his career. Last appearance in the Sweet 16 in 1994 at Indiana. But the key here for Texas Tech is to get the ball inbounds. Bob Knight is going to spend some time with his guys because you don't want the five-second call. Texas Tech still has two timeouts remaining. So if you can't get the ball inbounds right away, you have that luxury of a timeout that you can call. But you get the ball inbounds, and for Gonzaga, they don't have a lot of time to play around. Whoever gets the ball inbounds, you foul them immediately.
LaQuinte White coming in for the first time in the game for Texas Tech. Ross will inbound to Dora. Ross.
That's a nice job by Texas Tech. Not only a well-designed inbounds play, but well-executed. Dora catches the ball, and there's nobody around him, so that clock starts to tick, gets the ball back to Ross, and even though he does not have the highest free throw shooting percentage on the team, this is the guy I want at the line if I'm Texas Tech.
Randy Opik with his third foul for Gonzaga. Here is Ronald Ross, the walk-on, the captain. And with crucial free throws in front, he puts Texas Tech up by their biggest margin today of three.
And if he makes this one, then it's going to really take some miracle for Gonzaga to pull it out. Just not very much time left.
Six nothing run for Texas Tech. Rivio.
The two doesn't really help you here. Gonzaga has no timeouts.
And a quick foul, Morrison, as he fouls LaQuinte White. 1.2 to play.
Now, this is an interesting foul right here because LaQuinte White is in the game. He's only a 60% free throw shooter. And as you pointed out, Kevin, this is his first time in the game. You know, 1.2 seconds, though, if he misses, is not very much time. It's going to be one of those things where you get the rebound and you just have to heave it and hope.
But looking for the season, only 6 of 10. He has not made many trips to the stripe this season.
Now, those 1.2 seconds, even if he misses, Gonzaga has no choice but to take the ball and just heave it down to the other end. Every once in a while you see those, but that's what it's down to for the Zags right now. Now, Dora is in there, and if he misses, Dora does not want to pick up a foul going over anybody's back.
Hurry off. That's it. The Texas Tech Red Raiders will ride into Albuquerque and the Sweet 16. Points in the second half. Texas Tech has come back to win, and they will play the winner next week in Albuquerque of that Wake Forest West Virginia game. Our Chevrolet players of the game, Ronald Ross with 24 and Adam Morrison with 25, both with 9 rebounds. Texas Tech going to their first Sweet 16 since 1996. A big-time win for Bob Knight and the Red Raiders. For Dan Bonner, Kevin Harlan, so long from Tucson. We take a break, then take you to New York and Greg Gumbel here on CBS.
When you post your resume on...
Hi, How's that for the start to the day? Hi, everyone. Welcome once again as we continue to travel the road to the Final Four. I want to remind you what's coming up next. At about 3:20, we will tip in Boise. It'll be Pacific against Washington, and then game two in Tucson. We'll tip at 3:40. It'll be Utah against Oklahoma. What you just saw out of Tucson, Texas Tech over Gonzaga, 71-69. The Red Raiders come back to win it after the game. Dan Bonner with Coach Bob Knight.
All right, here we are with Coach Bob Knight. Coach, a tremendous comeback in the second half for your team, down 13. What was the difference?
Well, I think we just had a better attitude to play than we did. This is the best coach I know right here. We just had it. We had a better attitude in the second half, I think, than we had in the first half about play. It just seemed like we just weren't at the same level that Gonzaga was in the first half. And then I think in the second half, they had a chance to bust it on us and didn't. We hung in there, and then obviously we made some plays that were very big for us down the wire.
Now, I talked to Pat a little bit before the game, and he said that one of the concerns with your team is early in the year when they got behind, they didn't really seem to come back, but that the Iowa State game in the Big 12 tournament seemed to be a turning point.
Well, I don't know if it was a turning point. We came back and won that game. We've not been a really good team at having to score and being able to score. Today, I think we did. In the second half, when we had to get a point or a bucket, we were able to get it. Okay.
Thanks, Coach.
So Texas Tech's win takes Bob Knight to the Sweet 16 for the first time since 1994. We'll have more as we continue here on CBS in just a moment.
Since 1989, Coca-Cola has provided